Look, looks like we have a bigger problem than I thought. We're gonna have to keep the car here for a few days. So I offered your services to take Benicio and Irene home. Would that be okay?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
I don't have wheels in my car.
Okay.
That's one thing you should know about me.
We'll put the tires on.
You got 5 minutes?
Yeah.
All these priceless cars, one would think you'd have better locks.
My door's always open to you.
Going somewhere?
Thinking about it.
I'm looking for your driver.
You break in here, I figure it's bad news.
No, sir. It's bad luck. 2,000 heists a year in this city. He has to pick the wrong one.
He tried to put it right.
Well, he picked the wrong guy for that, too. My partner is a belligerent asshole with his back against the wall. Right now, so am I. If I don't set this straight, I'm in big trouble. Any idea where he might be?
Mexico. Maybe it was Belize.
Really? I was getting excited about this whole thing. My name on a car. I mean, look how beautiful. I wanted to see my name on this thing. I think we would have made a go at this business.
That's it. It's done.
to reread one of those stories. It was about a man who one morning wakes up and cannot bring himself to get out of bed. He shuts his eyes in self-defense. He re-examines his life, is seized with a restlessness. He packs his bags, cuts all ties. He can no longer live among the people he knows. They paralyze him. He is moneyed. He goes to Rome. He wants to burrow under the earth like a bulb, like a root. But even in Rome, he cannot escape people from his former life. So he decides to return to the city where he was born and educated, but which he can't quite bring himself to call home. Well, the move doesn't help. He feels he has no more right to return than a dead man. What can he do? He desires an extreme solution to his conundrum. He aches for nothing less than a new world, a new language. Nothing changes. Out of indifference, and because he can't think of anything better to do, he decides once more to leave his hometown, to do some hitching. A man picks him up, they ride off into the night, when bang, the car smacks into a wall. The driver dies. Our man is hospitalized, broken up. Months pass. His wounds heal. Now he wishes for life. He has a confidence in himself, in things he doesn't have to explain, things like the pores in his skin, all things corporeal. He can't wait to get out of the hospital, away from the infirm and the moribund. I say unto thee, rise up and walk. None of your bones are broken. The end. When I reread those words, rise up and walk, none of your bones are broken, I felt a tremendous sadness. Do you know what the opening line of the story is? When a man enters his 30th year, people will not stop calling him young. 30. I'd been given the book for my 30th birthday. The 30th Year by Ingeborg Bachmann. So I had heard. I had been told. I knew all along, even if I didn't really know. The great true things are unsurprising. But what did I do back then? I carried on. I carried on dutifully. We were the happy couple, Elizabeth and I. That's how people saw it. But in truth, I did not cherish my wife. And I did not cherish my friends. Or even my children. I just carried on. I was a success. I made my way. But with each step, I cringed. I was on the back foot, the defensive. And now, tonight, for the first time, I say, my bones are broken.
They need to see you. Sharon Specials, they get 10 million viewers. She is a crusader. If she takes you on
she's
as a
she's going pause, to ask real questions.
I would draw you, as if you're doing a deposition. What to say, what not to say.
A trained monkey?
A trained monkey who doesn't get lethal injection. Nick, this case is about what people think of you. They need to like you. Now you do this and you will reach millions of those people.
Maybe I only need to reach one.
Hello?
Hey, Daddy.
1 minute. Hey.
Hey. You clear now?
No, I'm just cleaning up.
Well, let us come in and say goodbye.
I'll come by that before...
Let us give you a hand. Yeah, you gotta clear everything out here. Dorothy is a real stickler. Not even a spare hanger can you leave behind. I'll make sure nothing's tucked inside. Sock or undies or what have you. You did a real good job. Where is the money, sweetheart?
Look under her dress.
He talked you into this?
I talked him into it.
Second you leave, I'm calling the cops.
Your glasses are fake. Your hair's dyed all hamster. You say her name's Nancy, but you don't even answer to it half the time. You're hiding, I don't know why, and I don't really care. But you ain't gonna call the cops. I don't think you've ever really been hit before.
No! Oh!
Get your fucking hands off.
Thanks.
Thank you.
you feeling well?
Pardon?
Are you in good health?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You go to sleep, you'll wake up. It'll be as if those hours never existed. You won't even dream. For an hour or two after you wake, you'll feel, yes, slightly groggy, but then fine. Perfectly fine. Not nearly as bad as a hangover. Such a sleep works wonders. You'll feel profoundly restored.